You know, last night, I know whoever came was unbelievable. I mean, it was unbelievable. And I think there is one thing that, besides enjoying the music, I learned something very important. I learned you can have great hazanim, each one is better than the other one, or all of them are great, and each one of them have his own special tune, his own special way of giving the music. So, say Chachamim, the same way, Keshem Shepartufeim Shonim, the same way that the faces are different, the same thing, the personalities and the neshama, the goal of each one of the neshamot is different. So yesterday, last night, I mean, was amazing how to see each one of the hazanim giving his own tune and his own special, special part in the music that the other hazan didn't have, but the other hazan have his own different part. Rabotai, there is a Gemara in Masechet Pesachim. The Gemara brings up a story. I believe it was Rav Kahana. And the Gemara writes that this Rav Kahana was walking. They invite him to give a speech, a shiur, in one of the cities. He gets to the city, and was Aleph Pesach, was before Pesach, so he decided to teach the people a concept that it's called Maim Shelanu. What's Maim Shelanu? Maim Shelanu, the halacha requires that the water that you will use for the baking of the matzot gotta be water that you took it from the river or whatever, yeah? After it was, and the whole entire night gotta be Shelanu. What's Shelanu? Shelanu is that they sleep. That they sleep. Shelanu. Danu. Okay? So it's Maim Shelanu. So the Rebbe was explaining this halakha. Next morning, Rabotai, the Gemara writes that there is a huge crowd coming up to the house of the rabbi, knocking on the door. Rabbi opens, yes, what can I help you? We came to get some water. What do you mean? They understood when the rabbi said, Maim Shelanu, they mean, what, my water, our water, Maim Shelanu. So the Gemara writes that obviously the rabbi explained to people that wasn't his kavanah. The kavanah is water that they slept in a kelly. And that's the story. Now, Rabotai, I have a question for you. What is this Gemara wanting to teach me? Gemara doesn't give stories, you know, funny stories, silly stories. Say the Chazonish, something amazing. He says, look what the Gemara is teaching us. Rav Kahana got to a city. No one in this city had Rav Kahana before. Rav Kahana wasn't living in that city. He came just to give a shiur. And imagine a huge crowd that we saw last night. Huge crowd coming to hear the shiur of Rav Kahana. And the rabbi stands up and he says, Rabotai, there is an halakha. The halakha is we need Maim Shelanu. And the people understood, everybody understood, what's Maim Shelanu? The water of the rabbi. Imagine the whole entire crowd and no one opened his mouth to say, oh, you're coming with new halachot, you're inventing things, whenever such a thing, hala, what are you talking about? No one opened his mouth. Not only no one opened his mouth, everybody came after the rabbi next morning to ask his own water. Say the Chazonish, this Gemara is teaching us what is the concept of Emunat Chachamim. That when the Chachamim are telling us some way that we have to take, there is no questions behind. Once we go for it till the end. That's Emunat Chachamim. And that's exactly what happened in this week's parasha. We are about to read about the father of Moshe Rabbeinu. And the Torah is telling us that he was Gadol Ador. He was the head of Am Yisrael. And he decided to stop being with his wife. Why? He said to himself, those Rashaim are taking the babies, they are killing them. For what? To have babies, to see them die in a few more days? He decided to stop bringing kids, Rabotai, was his own private decision. He didn't say they're going to shiur. He didn't publish it. His own private decision. And writes the Midrash that after he stopped being with his wife, all Am Yisrael, without even asking questions, they did the same exact things. Until Miriam and Neviah came up. Miriam, the little girl, 3 years old, according to some, 7 years old, came up to her father and he told her, "Daddy, you're worse than Paro. Paro, all these gezeraos and he's in the boys. You're doing the gezeraos also in the girls." Writes the Midrash what happened at that moment. He said, "You're right." He went back with his wife. At the second that he went back with his wife, all Am Yisrael followed him also. That's the concept of Emunat Chachamim. Rabotai, when a person has this Emunah, is ready to follow whatever the Gedolim are telling us, even without any question. I'm going to tell you, there was a story that I heard. After the Holocaust, the survivors came up to Eretz Yisrael. And there was a type of sickness, I forget the name of the sickness, although it was a very big disease. And a guy, his son Hazid, had this sickness. And the situation of the son was going worse and worse. One of his friends told him, "Listen, there is a huge rabbi over here, it's called the Chazon Ish. Go, ask him a beracha." He went to the Chazon Ish. The Chazon Ish told him, "Listen, there is a doctor, Dr. Ginsburg, I think it is, in this hospital. Go to his room, ask for an appointment. That today you wanted to see him." The guy said, "Okay." He took some money, you know, to pay the doctor. He went to the doctor's office. And the secretary asked him, "Yes, how can I help you? Listen, I have to see the doctor." He says, "You have to see the doctor? Do you see all those people? They're waiting already 3 weeks." He took the appointment. "And let me check next time." And she's starting to turn one page after the other in the calendar to see when she can give him an appointment. He says, "Habibi, I came here today. I'm entering today." She gets so angry. She started to yell on him. And he started to explain her back. Hope that again the doctor hears that. He goes out. "So what's the problem over here? So listen, this guy crazy wants to get in today without any appointment." And the guy tells the doctor, "Listen, I'm coming because the Chazon Ish told me to come. I'm entering to you today." Says the doctor, went inside his room. After 5 minutes, he comes out. He says, "Don't worry. Your son is not here. I know the hospital where he's being taken care. Everything is going to be okay. Go back to the hospital." So what do you mean? He became Mekuban. Well, he says, "No." What happened was that he made a phone call to that hospital and he said to all the doctors that he have, all his friends, "Guys, I want you to leave everything and take care of this child." He said all the doctors came and Baruch Hashem took him. His friend, the friend of this man that just his son got saved, also had his son with the same disease. So he decided also to go to the Chazon Ish. And he was expecting, go to Dr. Ginsburg. He gets to the Chazon Ish. Chazon Ish tells him, "You know, there is a doctor, it's called Dr. Deutsch. Go to this guy." He says, "Rabbi, but my friend was here." I said, "Did you hear what I said? Go to Dr. Deutsch." "Who is Dr. Deutsch?" He started to make some research. Dr. Deutsch is not anymore a doctor. He's 80 years old. The guy doesn't work anymore. So the friends of him told him, "Listen, maybe the Chazon Ish, you know, is still stuck a few years back. The guy is not working anymore as a doctor." He says, "I'm going." The Chazon Ish says, "To go, I go." He knocks at the door. The guy opens the door. "What can I help you?" "Listen, the Chazon Ish and this sickness." He says, "Amazing. I still have a medicine in my house that heals up this disease. And please don't pay me, because if the Chazon Ish sent you till here, I admire the Chazon Ish. Here, take it." But sometimes we don't even realize that when a person follows Da'at Torah, when a person understands that Emunat HaChamim is very powerful, then you will see only Yeshua. But let me go one more step on. The Torah writes, Ubnei Yisrael paru, vayishretzu, vayirbu, vayatzmu, bimod meod, vatimale haaretz otam. Say Chachamim, we learn it from here, that the women in Mitzrayim, each one had 6 babies at a time. Until today, we don't find such a thing. With all the technological movements. And every single lady had 6 children. And then writes the Torah, right after, Vatimaleha aretz otam, they fill up all the land of Mitzrayim. Then, Vayakum melech chadash al Mitzrayim asher lo yada Yosef. Then, a king, Paro came out and started to do tzarot. Rabotai, what did this have to do? Because they were filling up the land, that's why Paro was angry? The Mefashim writes something very, very strong. Say the Mefashim. Am Yisrael, they used to live in a country by name Goshen. In Goshen they have their Talmud Torah, their yeshivot, everything, their shuls, hazanim, whatever they wanted to. But they started to grow. Vatimale haaretz otam. They started to go out. They started to get involved with the goyim. They wanted to be part of the goyim. Go to the cinema. Go to the theaters. And they started to act like them. What's the result? Say the mefarshim immediately. Vayakom melech hadash Mitzrayim asher lo yada Yosef. A new king came up to Mitzrayim and he started to do all the problems. You know, they give a mashal. I don't know if it's a mashal, a true story. Happened, a guy that have very wealthy man had his daughter, Shidduchim, 18 years old. So the father approached the daughter and he asked her, tell me whenever you will be ready to, you know, to go out, and Be'ezat Hashem will find a great boy, everybody wants you. After 2 weeks, she comes back to her father, Daddy, I'm ready. Oh, okay, let me make just a few phone calls to Shadchanim. Everything is going to be okay. She said, no, Daddy, I'm ready. I'm ready to get married. I have the boy already. Mm-hmm. Have the boy? Which boy? What are you talking about? She says, yes, you know, Jackie from the guy that is all the day in the streets drinking. No, Daddy, stop talking about Jackie. Like, Dad, he's such a good boy. He has a sweetheart. It's amazing. And the dad couldn't believe it. His beautiful daughter, there's nothing that they're missing in the house. She's going to get married to the most low-class guy in town. He didn't know what to do. He started to convince her and his daughter there's nothing what to talk with her. He decided to go to his rabbi. Told him, Rabbi, please, I don't know what to do. The rabbi said, one second, who told you that the guy is a bad guy? What do you mean who told me? Go ask whoever, everybody knows him. The rabbi said, but maybe it's Lashon Hara. He says, Rabbi, one thing I'm going to tell you. My daughter is not getting married to this boy. I said, okay, relax. Listen, there is a Gemara. The Gemara writes that you can check up a person by 3 things. Bekiso, bekoso, or bekaso. There is 3 ways to check up a person. You want to know his personality? 3 ways. Bekiso, flus. Okay, check him, take a little bit of money, take out from him money, and see how he acts. Bekoso, when he drinks a little, he's going high. Also, you can check how his personality. Ubekaso. And at the moment that he gets angry. Listen, I recommend you to do something. Make an engagement party. Okay, huh? Yes, I want you to make an engagement party. Do it big. Tell your daughter that you agree for the engagement party. And by the Ashkenazim, you know, they break a plate. When they break a plate, that's it. Once they break a plate in the engagement, it's like it's already a semi-wedding. To break an engagement after breaking a plate is very delicate.
Really?
Yeah. So the rabbi tells him, before you break the plate, buy a nice, high quality whiskey. You know, something, I don't know the prices, Habibi, $200, $300.
Blue label.
I believe that it's better. You're gonna buy something like that, all the guys are giving him a regular L'chaim. You're gonna take the boy, you're gonna give him a little bit of... Says the night came, all the shul was there, all the people in town were there. And to make the long story short, L'chaim, L'chaim, and he pours to the Hatan, Jackie, he pours him the great whiskey. And the guy drinks the whiskey, oh, it's a good one. Guru, you like it? And he started pouring more. And more and more, and the guy started to drink. And when he started to drink, he started to go high and high. And Rabotai, at the beginning, he sold the food. You know, before the engagement, the girl told him, Jackie, please behave. Today you have to behave, you want our father. And the guy forget about all what the girl told him. And he started to eat like an animal. And then he started to push one guy and another guy. It was a whole mess. The girl approaches the boy and tells him, listen, behave. You want to get married. Don't be tipesh. And he was so drunk, he pushed her and he kicked her. But minan, what happened at the end of the story? Rabotai, until the girl wasn't able to take it anymore, she screamed, Daddy! Help me out! Daddy came, he gave him, you know, he threw him out of the house. Say Chachamim, that's exactly what HaKadosh Baruch Hu is telling us. But Olam tells us, listen, you're so special. I'm going to give you a great shidduch. No, God, I want to manage myself. With who? Yeah, outside in the streets. Let me be like everybody. Let me be like those guys over here and those guys over there. But Tzei Chachamim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will never allow Am Yisrael to be destroyed by getting married to Goyim and by being assimilated. And if we don't understand it in the right way, Bar Minan, you will have to do all the whole thing to make us those guys, to make us suffering, and then we will cry to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and He will save us. ובני ישראל פרו וישרצו וירבו ויעצמו כמו לא נותנים עלי הארץ אותם. They went out outside Goshen to be like the Goyim. Then לא עלינו ויקום מלך חדש המצרים. That's a message for us. רבותיי, חן, how you say חן in English?
Gracia.
חן, חן. חן is the grace, this grace that we can give outside to the street to the Goyim. It's not depending on how we're going to try to look in front of their eyes. It's depending, first of all, Limtzohen Be'ene Elokim and then Be'ene Adam. First, we have to do whatever HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants. And if we follow whatever HaKadosh Baruch Hu is asking from us, then HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to give. Chen B'nei Yisrael to Mitzrayim. Baruch Adonai Le'olam. Amen.